I have a couple small mini rants at the top. One is NGuy. I would like to thank you for your years as a colleague, and I hope to see more of you and all of your luminous hair. Secondly, if the gentleman who is twittering as me is out in the audience, I have a word for you. Stop twittering as me. All right, I had a couple of topics I was going through my head about what I was going to do. Actually, this one kind of came about probably the last 24 hours. I titled it, Fuck Metacritic. Who the hell are you kidding? More or less, recently I ran into a developer, a high-level developer. We've had a great relationship. They've been on the show. I knew their company. And this guy was pissed at me. I mean, I'm talking like he said, fuck you to me. It was about a review. We had given a review. We do a 1-to-5-point scale. I'll just say it right now. I hate actually attributing a number to a game, but unfortunately, we have to do that. So, more or less, it was a 2. And I realized in the course of me trying to explain the nature of the review, which my reviewer had written, that he hadn't read the review. What he had done is he had gone to Metacritic, who had decided that my 2 was equivalent to a 40. And with the average of that game, it dragged it down significantly. I'd like to point out that I contacted Metacritic on several occasions and said, really, that's not how we do it. There's a reason why we have a 1-to-5-point scale. And, you know, it's not like everything's equitable in that. And they said, no, you're wrong. It's my scale. Really? Really, it is. So, unfortunately, this guy got hurt. And it's really frustrating to see that because I have a certain point scale and someone's trying to recalibrate it, really take my work and then try to put it onto a 100-point scale. I don't even understand what a 100-point scale is. Somebody in the room, tell me the difference between 73 and 74. I'm kind of lost on that one. I know I did it on my Killzone 2 rant, but I had to bring it back. It really is a problem. Obviously, it's just kind of odious when we in the press are seeing sort of our work retranslated and recalibrated, where we're not really claiming the ownership and suddenly there's this number attached to it. More odious than that, I'm just gonna go ahead and say it. It's no secret that Metacritic is being used as a means of withholding remuneration to you guys out there, and that's bullshit. And that makes me feel awful, being the guy who still wants to tell the truth about what his opinion is of a game could actually cost you your job, cost you some money that you were planning to get so you could pay off some debts. I mean, it's absolutely ridiculous. And so I fault Metacritic for allowing this situation to happen where they just kind of pick and choose. And I do mean pick and choose who goes up on that site and doesn't respect the wishes of those people who are having their reviews recalibrated on that site. But really, shame on you, the publishers, for actually using that as a criteria to determine if the game was good. You're relying on us? Really? Think about it. I don't think we could pitch a tent together, more or less come up with a unanimous decision on the quality of your work. And I think everybody who's on this panel would also say, we don't want you to make a game for us, we want you to make the good game that you want to make. Sometimes we'll like it, sometimes we won't. So shame on you, every single publisher that's pulling this stunt. You want to know if the game is good or not? There's this really, really effective tool to do that. The market! It's being sold! Does it sell well? Does it not? And you know what? If it's a good game, you know it's a good game, it doesn't sell well, go talk to your marketing staff. All right? Don't put it on us. I'm sorry this is happening to you. I want to put a stop to it. Maybe somehow we'll all get together, we'll march down to CNET, we'll flip them the bird, and maybe somebody in that building will take a long, hard look at something that they're putting online that is odious, pernicious, and needs to stop now. Thank you very much.